Good morning, and welcome to another episode of Old Men in Chairs. It's another Monday morning, and I have not recorded for a week because I've been sick. You may recall last Monday I had a little scratch in my throat. Well, that scratch became full-on bronchitis by the end of the week, which luckily I'm now just getting over. I was kind of happy, actually. Tom MacDonald came out with his song Riot on Friday, which I had absolutely no interest in reacting to. And since I wasn't feeling that well anyway, it was a little bit of a relief. I love Tom, but I guess I'm too old to understand some of his stuff. I know in hip-hop, there's a big tradition of boosting about how great you are. And Tom has done a number of songs on that theme. And I have no argument that he is great. He's on the Mount Rushmore of independent rap artists, as far as I know. But I don't get much out of that kind of a song. I'm interested in the social messages that he has in many of his other songs. And then the video itself, I must be too old for it, because I think a lot of that CGI work, you know, based on video games, or maybe modern movies that I'm just not familiar with. So it may be great technical work. I don't really care about it. So I hope you had a great Tom weekend. I didn't really spend a lot of time watching reactions to that song. I watched a few. If I don't understand a song, I'm not gonna react to it. I'm not gonna do Tom MacDonald just to try to get more views and pretend that I love the song when I don't even understand it. Because I've been away a week, I got quite a bit to say, but I'm going to do things a little differently. I'm actually going to play this song, The Animals, We Gotta Get Out of This Place, once through complete, at least one verse and one chorus, which only takes a minute and a half. And then I will come back and do it again and break it down and have a lot to say about the song. But I don't want to keep everybody waiting.
Ladies and gentlemen, here from England, The Animals. So let's have a fine welcome.
In this sturdy old part of the city, where the sun refused to shine, yeah, people tell me there ain't no use in trying. So young and pretty, and one thing I know is true, you'll be dead before your time is due. I know it. See, my daddy ain't bad in time. His hair been turning gray. He's been working and slaving his life every day. Oh yes, I know it now, 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 now.
Many people have had that feeling in many different situations, but in my case, getting out of high school, you know, getting away from the regimentation of every day you go get up and you go to school for 12 long years, and you get to the point, like, especially, you know, I graduated in 1968, well, so much going on in the 60s, and we just need to get out of that place. But one of the famous class pranks that was pulled at my particular school was that someone got into the organ system. We used to sing, you know, hymns in the morning. The whole school would assemble, the whole upper school, you know, maybe 9th through 12th grade, which would have probably been 250 to 300 people, kids and teachers, would all assemble every morning for a brief, you know, orientation for the day, a few hymns. Somebody got into that organ system so that in the middle of the headmaster's remarks, all of a sudden this song came blasting at full volume through the speaker system. The poor organist had no idea how to turn it off. And we loved it. It was one of the greatest moments of our high school career, because no one knew it was coming. And of course, we all knew the song and we all knew the sentiment. Whoever did that, I never did find out who did that, but whoever did that was genius. The Animals were one of the earliest British invasion groups. They came out of the British city of Newcastle, which was kind of a gritty industrial city in the northeast of England. They changed the lyrics. Actually, the song was written by an American couple, but they got a hold of it and they changed the lyrics, and they talk about the dirtiest part of the city where the sun refused to shine. Well, that was pretty much Newcastle. It was a coal town, very dirty, very gritty. Their first hit had already come out in 1964, which was a number one hit in America, House of the Rising Sun. Again, an American folk song perhaps, although it may have had British origin, but it was best known as an American folk song about the city of New Orleans. They took an electric version of it and took it to number one in America. Very revolutionary. Probably the first folk rock song that ever came out. So they were already a well-known commodity. In fact, I think they had 8 top 10 hits in their short run as a band. The band only lasted about 4 years. You know, from the first hits in 64, by 68, they were pretty much disbanded. Although the lead singer, Eric Burdon, came up with a whole nother band, which she called Eric Burdon and the Animals, and they actually moved to California and continued to produce some popular music after that, but the original band was gone by 1968. But this appearance on the Ed Sullivan Show actually occurred in February of 1966. It was actually their 5th appearance on the Ed Sullivan Show. For those who don't realize, you know, I guess it's famous that the Beatles were on Ed Sullivan in February of 1964. The Animals' first appearance on Ed Sullivan was not that much later, September of the same year, 1964. And they had a total of 6 appearances till the band broke up. But this was their 5th appearance, so they were veterans at this. But in those days, this was how young people found out about new groups, new music. There weren't a lot of alternatives. We didn't have an MTV or a video channel. Some of the music would appear, of course, on Top 40 Radio, but as far as really getting to see the bands perform, Ed Sullivan was one of the biggest. So he was introducing a lot of the British Invasion bands coming and appearing on his show. And we watched it pretty religiously back then, just to see these new bands and what they're made of. Notice the very British mod look. You know, the band is all wearing the same black and white suits, very well put together. I'm going to restart the video and break it down slower.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, you're from England. The Animals. So let's have a fine welcome.
So right there, 2 things. Of course, Ed Sullivan was known for his very quirky stage mannerisms. In fact, many, many comedians loved to do impressions of Ed and the way he moved his body in kind of a spastic way and his voice. He was iconic in himself. But the first opening, the bass line there by Chaz Chandler, very, very famous bass line. Chaz is also perhaps even more famous for his work after leaving the Animal. He didn't even last to 68, I don't believe. He discovered Jimi Hendrix in New York City, convinced Hendrix to go to England, recruited the other two members of the Jimi Hendrix Experience, and was very, very involved in recording the first two or three albums of the Jimi Hendrix Experience, which are considered some of the greatest music of that era. Jimi Hendrix generally regarded as the greatest electric guitar player in history. So Chaz had quite an ear for talent and created a lot of that sound people my age all grew up on. Very talented fella. The band itself is extremely tight. If you listen to the actual recorded version of this song, it's very well put together. You can hear each instrument, you know, the bass line, the rhythm guitar, the organ, and of course, a very strong vocal performance by Eric Burdon. He has that bluesy, gritty voice. This particular version is live. That's another thing. Back in the day, a lot of times people would lip sync and they would play a recorded version of the song and then they would pretend that they were performing it. It was probably a lot easier to do it that way. To reproduce the studio sound live in a theater like this, it was not easy. And you can tell there's a lot of variation from the studio version here, particularly with the vocal. The vocal, he's working that vocal track a lot more than the studio version.
In the studio part of the city, where the sun refused to shine, yeah, people tell me there ain't no use in trying. Now my girl, you're so young and pretty, and one thing I know is true, you'll be dead before your time is due. I know it.
Pretty powerful lyric there, you know, young girl, you're so young and pretty, but you ain't gonna survive the city. You're gonna be dead before your time is due. It's kind of a depressing song, the verse. That all leads, builds the tension for the chorus.
See my daddy in bed in time. His hair been turning gray, yeah. He's been working and slaving his life every day. Oh, yes, I know it now.
You know the chorus is coming, but what a great build-up to the chorus. And this was a song that probably every garage band, rock and roll group tried to perform because, you know, the great call and response, yeah, 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 yeah. Similar to another great garage band song, Gloria, you know. It just builds that tension back and forth, and then leads up to the release in the chorus here.
We gotta get out.
Not only did people coming to the end of their educational careers have that feeling of needing to get out of this place, this song was immensely popular among the soldiers stationed in Vietnam. It was probably the most popular song in Vietnam on Armed Forces radio, constantly being requested because if you were serving in Vietnam, well, then you wanted to get out of that place as soon as possible. And so the song became very popular there, and it's used in a lot of Vietnam war movies of that era. This song did make it to number 13 on the American charts in 1965. But let's hear that chorus one more time, just for old time's sake.
Help somebody. Girl, that's a better life for me and you. Somewhere, baby, I know it. And you know it. Believe me, baby.
I suppose there's people out there that might be critical in some cases, that I tend to look at old songs and then apply them to issues of today. And in some cases, perhaps there's a stretch, but there's no question about this song. This song is universal. In other words, when we say we gotta get out of this place, well, this country's in a very bad place right now. That's no secret. And so I think this rings true today, more than it ever has in the last 60 years. We've got to get out of this place. We've got to find a way out of all the negativity that we're experiencing and all the bad things that are happening in so many areas. So let this be our anthem. Let's get out of here. One final note. I did receive a phone call last week from my partner, Howard. He ended up in the hospital last week for 4 days, and he was calling me. He was about to be released, and he's going to be put on some new medications, and he's optimistic that he can bring his health back around and maybe someday get back over here and sit next to me. So it was really good to hear from Howard, and I hope he continues to recover.